Gosh, dug it, yo. I had the title and pull up the screen, and there's 31 road crew already clamoring for my seat. Good morning, everybody. They are predicting 10 inches here. Winter storm warning. Snow and ice and everything until Monday morning. Traffic is moving. We already checked all the weather and all that other good stuff. Checked the roads. The roads are ugly. But we're gonna make a go of it, slow and easy. So that's all we could do. Got a cup of coffee, and that's one of the most important things. Shouldn't have come out this way. We obviously are not going to make our delivery on time.
Proceed east on I-90 east in 123 miles. Exit left 2, I-94 east.
Whoa, which... I guess we're on too late. Bridges, you gotta be careful of the bridges. Slow and easy, we're not out here to impress anybody. Good side is it ain't snowing on us. Don't know where Montana's snow plows are. Get the first hill done out of the way. Today's not the day to play Super Trucker. got all day to get wherever we're getting. In fact, we got all the time in the world to get there safely. You're gonna hear that hazard light all dang day while we're going slow. Truck I would not want to drive in the winter. The dang wiggle wagon. Montana had snow clouds, but I guess not. There we go. wonder, do you think today would be a good day for a Segway ride? See where the edge of the road is. And look, these cars are going in the middle of the highway instead of on their own side. Probably can't see it on camera, but the shoulder has got unplowed snow on it. Of course, the wipers ain't doing worth a flip. Well, that's really nice. And then you wonder why truck drivers get into an accident. This is exactly because of idiots like that. That's just dumb. can't even see out the windshield. Yay! First part of this is dang wipers never work. I don't care. You can put a brand new one because as soon as the wipers start accumulating ice, then nothing clears, you know? Now we're about to go down mountains. All those fat moo cows to the right, they don't care if it's cold. Carnage ditch, the first one of the day. Looks like everybody's all right though. Just a little slide off. Thank you, I appreciate it. Alright, we got a truck, a pickup truck, it looks like facing facing us in our road, in our right here on our side of the road, pickup truck. That somebody's gonna slide into him. I haven't seen that for a while. Y'all see that car, that pickup truck facing the wrong way? Yeah, today's not the day to be super drunk. There you go. I've done 11, and I don't know. I always take my time. I got nowhere to be. Deliveries could always be rescheduled. case you guys get buffering, remember we are still in the mountains. You know, even even though it's snowing and you guys want to see everything, I'm getting indications that we're buffering. Part of life out here. The official first snow day. Big Rig Travels coming to you live from Montana, just east of Livingston. We're not on any time schedule. Our time schedule is out the window today. That's the least of our concern. Ain't nobody on the road but us, hardly. know who you are, but we ain't talking on the phone right now. There's another car in the ditch, but he looks like he was there last night. Number one vehicle I see in the ditches is a FedEx wiggle wagon and UPS wiggle wagon. If it gets a little hard for you guys to see, because the windshield wipers are getting iced up, I'll stop and clear them if there's a spot to pull over. You can't even see where the traffic lanes are. beginning to think we should have just stayed where we were. It'd be a little bit better if it would get up a little bit warmer. Or stop snowing, or both. That's too fast. Yay, slide. Another mountain pass coming up. You ain't even see anything. Yay, blizzard. Where's the rest area, man? We're going to try to clear our ice off the windshield. Yes, I see the stop sign. Yes, we're going to roll through it because I don't see anybody coming and I'm not going to get stuck in the ice there because that's on the hill. But I've got to clean these windshield wipers. Bit better. All right. That's a bad thing about this mess. Is the windshield wipers get ice going. We got a snowplow coming up. Yay! And we're about to get dumped on. You guys probably missed it, but we just got dumped on by a snowplow. These cars are driving and you can't even see. That's exactly how pileups happen. I got a truck. I've got a big truck, probably 15 feet off of my rear end. You need to pass me. Another truck in it, or another car in the ditch. How many is that? I hope somebody's keeping track. Listen to the CB, you hear somebody else hollering about wipers and windshield being frozen over. So, I don't know, is somebody keeping track of how many vehicles we saw in the ditch? remember, everybody that's watching, you got Christmas coming up. If you follow one of my Amazon links, you can help support this web channel. Go to the website, to the very bottom of the blog is the Amazon link. Click that, do your shopping like normal, and I'll get credit for whatever you buy. It definitely helps. You know, if school kids have a snow day, why can't truck drivers have snow days? Like today. You know what? Somebody ought to tell the Weather Channel that we're broadcasting live from the snow. So maybe they'll do a little snippet on us driving through the snow in Montana. That's weather related, right? Somebody ought to do it. In fact, I dare somebody to tell the Weather Channel. Maybe we'll get our video up on the Weather Channel now. To be honest, I don't even know if we're still broadcasting. Sheriff has got his lights on over there. We actually went up one night, 1 degree, 9 degrees right now. Here's another cop. So I guess maybe behind us the pileup happened, I don't know. And the thing is, y'all can help spread the word by getting us on the TV and the news networks and all that mess. I can't personally do it because it just seems funny. It seems like I'm, I don't know, doing it myself. But if you viewers want to help spread the word to everybody, you could do exactly that. We've been on the radio in Ohio, in Chicago, been on a TV show in Brazil, been in a couple of newspapers and PC magazine, Trucker News, bunch of stuff. So yeah, get the word out. Thank you. can't even tell which lane to be in. Pull over and do the windshield wiper. Another wiggle wagon coming up. What is this up here? Is this a big truck in a ditch? I can't tell. No. It's an orange box. I thought it would be the cab of the truck. But it wasn't. Good thing. Ain't playing games out here, y'all. I've been getting so many emails from people wanting to see winter driving. I kept saying, no, not yet, not yet, not yet. Well, now today's your thing. Today, you're getting plenty of it. If it would quit snowing, you wouldn't have to use the wipers and y'all could probably get a better picture. How far to Billings? Hurry up, fly by me. Hey, R234 trailer, you realize you got a flat tire on your trailer there, right side. You don't care. That, the eastbound truck, R234, I didn't catch the name, but R234 is on the back trailer road. Dreading and about to come off your road. Yeah, flat tire's not working. Flat tire is definitely not what you want.
Hey,
I hear you. I'm still poking along. Be careful. So this is the Big Rig Travels version of Ice Road Truckers. If it quit snowing, we could, like, let the wipers stop, but... Where's the rest area when you need one or another pull-off? I know I've heard of people selling heated windshield wipers, but I've never heard another trucker tell me if they work or not. Didn't even see the lane or the road. So, every now and then people tell me that because they watch my channel, they want to become truckers. So, I'm going to ask that question now. Do you see what I'm driving through? Do you still want to be a truck driver? I would much rather have this going on during the daylight where I could see, halfway see, than pitch black at night like we were last night. You know, if you're gonna winter drive, do it during the day. Actually, for as crummy as it is out here, I'm surprised we ain't seen more people than it did. That's entirely too fast. In my opinion, like I said, when it comes to this mess, I don't care if people think I'm a super trucker or not. I don't play that game. You be super trucker in a ditch. It's like the tortoise and the hare. Tortoise and a rabbit or whatever. Monkey and a squirrel, something. I wonder if we're on ABC News today, on the ABC News app. Thank you. ministerial sign. Thank you. rest area coming up. Pulling here and clean some ice off the windshield and wipers, and make sure our headlights, taillights, and side marker lights are all clear of snow and all that good stuff. Then we'll continue on. Get some of the snow out of the way. Read this message somewhere along the way it came in. Okay. Now we got our next trip. Let me accept this trip real quick and then we'll hit the road again. Next trip heads us south, thank goodness. Okay, let's go.
Enter trip idle in 60 seconds. A new message has arrived. Home. Messaging.
Alright, let's go. Let's go somewhere. Let's do it to it! Ranch scenery in the snow like this.
Attention, a new important message has arrived.
Too bad, I can't hear. At least it quit snowing, so that's a big plus. I like being able to see where I'm going. Picked up any new viewers, if you go to the BigRigTravels.com website, you can see my speedometer, the trip map, where we're going, where we've been, over 50,000 photographs, Segway videos, and just this week I opened up drone videos. So there's a lot to the Big Rig Travels website if you just poke around. And of course, it cost me about $550 a month to run the website. And we broadcast live all of our trips, day and night, snow, sunshine. If the wheels are rolling, the truck's rolling, the cameras are rolling. Unedited, live as long as we have a signal. I was gonna make a new blog this morning, but I got distracted by other things. I'll make one tonight. And yesterday I uploaded a video that we took yesterday coming down Lookout Pass in Montana. So whenever Ken the moderator gets to it, he'll open that up. And y'all can check out Lookout Pass from yesterday. Hoping, really, really, really hoping, we open up we start pre-ordering for the Big Rig Travels 10-year, million-mile anniversary t-shirt. I thought I'd be able to do it this week, but I'm hoping really soon. Just got one or two more steps to do, and We'll start ordering. Actually, I'm pretty surprised. Everybody in Montana seems to be behaving pretty well. I don't know, the six or seven accidents we saw last night in the jackknife rig and whatnot. But today, people have been pretty well behaved. The view going faster than what I would like to do, but hey, to each his own. the snow probably moved on into North Dakota. So I don't know how far it'll be before we get out of this mess. We'll see. No real timeline right now. The only timeline we have is to get parked safely at the end of each day. Another car in a ditch. We are actually at 31 degrees now. Which now we're getting slosh. Or slot. Flashing lights up here. uh-oh, that truck hit that car, or that car hit that truck. You see guardrail damage? See the four-wheeler over there in the ditch? Maybe we're seeing the end of the mess for a while. Looks like it's clearing up quite a bit from what it was earlier. You still got to be careful. There's still hidden secret spots where it gets slick, especially on the bridges. A lot of people get a false sense of security and start speeding up quite a bit and then hit a slick spot and then it's all over. We're still at 31. Crossing over the Yellowstone River. Thank you. are like behaving pretty well. Maybe we'll be out of this mess shortly. Control right now, of course. Montana, 47 miles away. I can actually breathe easier now. This ain't bad, you know, where you can see the lines. Thank you. probably gonna have to put more windshield washer fluid in. When we get to Billings, somebody has to buy me a cup of coffee. I think we earned it today. Looks like we'll probably be cleared of Billings. Still don't know what North Dakota's got, but we'll deal with that when we get there. Guys, but dang, it's nice to see, it's nice to actually see some blacktop and the highway lines. Definitely got some good footage of winter driving this morning. It'd be nice if somebody actually used it. rest area coming up, but we don't need to clean our windshield. We are at 31 degrees and the windshield is clear, unlike earlier. on pretty good pretty good roads here. Beep you heard is my front radar blocked, probably due to the slush and ice on it. So right now we're driving without radar capability, but that's fine. I can clearly see in front of me now, unlike earlier. Out of the snow altogether now, or we got more junk in Lyle City in North Dakota and all that mess. I'll have to stop and check the weather. I don't know exactly which direction and how far the snow went. I know when I looked at radar this morning, snow was up in North Dakota, but didn't take time to see how bad the roads were. I figure one step at a time. Besides, in weather like this, anything can change at a moment's notice, so. Alright, we got our radar back. So that must mean the snow melted off our radar up front, which is always a good thing. Degrees. Nice. We may be out of it for a while. We got a weigh station coming up. our way station 2 mile marker. See what the great state of Montana is going to do. They're going to give us a green light or a red light. Red light! That means everybody needs to behave as we roll the truck in front of the scales. Looks like nobody gets a free pass today. Boy, they're eyeballing every truck. Pretty good if we're moving this slow. Alright, looks like they're happy with us.
Thank you.
we're gonna come in here and get a cup of coffee. I think I earned it. See if I can't pry my fingers off the steering wheel. We still have 3 hours and 40 minutes to drive before our half hour break. So we'll keep the cameras going. And just come in here, get coffee real quick. Are you stopping? There we go. Too bad this ain't a real Flying J though. Gonna turn? Clean the windshield a little bit. Alright, pop in here for coffee, I'll be right back. Now get yourself a cup of coffee as well.
Home. Messaging.
All right. Fake pilot coffee is better than no pilot coffee.
You have 3 hours and 28 minutes of remaining drive time.
Wow. I just looked at my little board here and it said we hit 362 simultaneous viewers. Very, very, very nice. That's what? It's more than 100 from our all-time record going over Snoqualmie Pass. What is this? We were on the Weather Channel? Seriously? Aww. Really? We were on the Weather Channel? Hey, okay, cool. So, how far is this? Let's see. All right, this is a 3.5 hour broadcast. Let's go ahead and stop this video here in Billings and then come right back in 2 seconds and start another broadcast. That way, what we have with the snow this morning will be sealed and archived and all that good stuff. So